Welcome to Olympic Stadium for the seventh day of track and field coverage. We shift our attention now to the pole vault, and here are the records. Sergei Bubka, the only man over 20 feet, and he set the Olympic record back in Seoul. And there is Sergei Bubka waiting for the bar to get up to his starting height. Three-time world champion in the event, but up for his first attempt at 18.8 and a quarter. 26-year-old resident of Barcelona, Javier Garcia. And boy, does he have the hometown advantage here. This crowd really behind him. And he acknowledges the crowd. Spanish athletes have done wonderfully well at these games in track and field. Antonio Penalver, the decathlete, improving by 100 points to win the silver. Garcia here jumping very well. His personal best is 18.11 indoors, but normally in big competitions, he just isn't in the hunt. But over cleanly at 18.8 and a quarter, he is in contention at this point in the competition. At 5'9 and 160, he's small by most pole vaulter standards, but this man is the consummate pole vaulter body. Bubka getting ready for his first attempt at this height. In the pole vault world, there isn't anything that he hasn't done. In track and field, pole vault and Bubka are synonymous. He has become the man who never loses. In 8 years, Sergei Bubka has set 30 world records. He's the first and only man to vault over 20 feet. Every time he stands at the head of a runway, he's expected to win. He's expected to break yet another record. He's expected to achieve what no other can. But there was a time when nothing was expected of Sergei Bubka. He grew up in a small town in Ukraine, then a part of the Soviet Union. His father was a sergeant in the Red Army who voiced such disapproval of Bubka's early vaulting that Sergei left home at 15 with his older brother, Vasily, to train in the coal mining city of Donetsk. But as his talent quickly developed, so did a feeling of isolation living in the Soviet Union.
We had a lot of problems in history and also now. It was many, many years like alone. We didn't have enough information from the world, real information.
But information came easier to Bubka because he was a privileged Soviet athlete. After traveling to track meets in Western cities with his family, where stores overflowed with items he could never buy in his own country, Bubka welcomed Ukraine's recent move to a free economy and a break with the Soviet Union. For Bubka, freedom meant he was allowed to make money from track meets and commercial endorsements. Today he can earn as much as $100,000 in appearance fees and bonuses from meet organizers, along with a $20,000 perk from his sponsor, Nike, for breaking a world record. That's $120,000 in a single evening. His annual income is estimated at $1.5 million. Compare that to the $385 he netted for each world record under Soviet rule, and you find a man who has become what he once could never be, a capitalist. You might call Bubka the Bo Jackson of Europe for his cross-training ethic as portrayed in his commercials. In competition, he's supremely efficient, getting the most out of every world record by moving the bar up only a small increment at a time. Still, with each centimeter, he moves farther into history and farther away from his competition.
Each 1 centimeter is very important for me.
But with each record that falls, the crossbar rises. And today, Bubka's biggest challenge may be living up to the illusion that his miracles will never end. Where the end will come is anyone's guess, because with every vault, Sergei makes us believe, if only for a fraction of a second, he will never come down. Bubka has said he thinks he can jump 20 feet 6 inches under the right conditions. Here's his first attempt at his normal opening height, 18.8 and a quarter. Oh boy, he just rode it out. He must have been so far under he couldn't go for the bar, but more importantly, now he has a miss in the competition, and oftentimes the medals will come down to who has the fewest misses. Very unusual to see Bubka missing at his opening height. You can see the wind gauge there. It really isn't doing anything in particular. We know there are swirling winds in this end of the stadium. Watch his right arm. It just gets jerked back. He had no chance of going for the bar, so he just bailed out. But now the whole point of starting high is lost because he has a miss. Plus, he has to make some adjustments. And with the wind, if he's up and the wind's in his face, he only has 2 minutes to go. So it's just one of those things. Now, here is one of his teammates, Igor Tredenkov. He had to qualify through a trials process. Bubka was put on the team, one of very few unified team members placed on the team. Tredenkov was second in their trials. This is his first attempt at 18.8 and a quarter. And the long, lanky Russian from St. Petersburg, 6'3", 165 pounds, over 18.8 and a quarter on his first attempt. That's his teammate, Maxim Tarasov, telling him where he planted. You can see here he hits his hips right over the bar, almost brushes with the knee. But he's over on his first attempt. Tarasov telling him what he needs to do, what adjustments he needs to make. But very unusual to see Sergei Bubka missing on the first attempt, and he realizes that he's having some problems with what he's doing. When we come back, the women will take to the track for the sprint relay. Okay, Tom, Sergei Bubka on the runway for his second attempt, which is unusual in itself. He never starts lower than 18.8 and a quarter, and he's getting into a trouble with the time clock. He only has 2 minutes to jump. He's down to 15 seconds, so even if the wind isn't like he wants it to be, he's got to go now. Oh, boy. Two misses at his opening height. Almost unheard of for Sergei Bubka in the last 2 years. Now he's got to go down to a third attempt. He took no warm-up jumps whatsoever. This is a shock. You can see there 10 seconds on the clock. If his run-up had not been good, he would not have been able to abandon it. He just has to go with it. Watch his right arm, how it's pulled back. Now, he's strong enough to usually come out of that. His hips are plenty high enough. But he was too close on the other side and dislodged the bar on the way down. He'll be facing a third attempt, his final attempt at his opening height. Without question, the most prohibitive favorite in this meet. Let's go back to Tom Hammond. Okay, Todd, it's just this simple. Sergei Bubka on the runway. This is his final attempt. The bar's been moved to 18.10 and a quarter. He misses this, and he's out of the Olympics. Unbelievable. Sergei Bubka, three times he jumped, three times he misses. The most prohibitive favorite going into these Olympic Games in track and field. He had plenty of time left on the clock. He had about a minute left. Watch his right arm. It jerks back a little bit, but I've seen him jump world records with a plant like that. Slams into the bar on the way up with his legs. Incredible. The medals are now wide open. Let's go back to Tom Hammond.
All right, Dwight, another shocking turn of events here at the Olympics. The perennial world record setter, shades of Dan O'Brien, Bubka, no hiding in the pole vault.
I tell you, don't know what's going on in track and field. Michael Johnson not making the finals in the 200 meter, O'Brien and Lewis not even being here in their specialties.
It has been a game of surprises.
Okay, Tom, this is Maxim Tarasov of the unified team, and aside from that bronze medal from the World Championships, he's also the world junior record holder, just 21 years old. And with that clearance, he is the gold medalist in the pole vault. Maybe the next generation of Sergei Bubka, but on this day in Barcelona, that man, Sergei Bubka, missed three times at his opening height. He walks away from Barcelona with nothing, and this young 6'4", 21-year-old from Russia is the gold medalist in the pole vault. 6'4", 180, built totally different from Bubka, has great leverage and jumped 19 feet as a 19-year-old. So the future seems very bright for Maxim Tarasov. Unified team so strong and so deep with pole vaulters that they won not only the gold medal, but the silver medal as well. So Tarasov, Olympic champion in the pole vault. Who would have thought coming into Barcelona that Bubka would not come away with the gold? Tarasov the gold, Tredenkov the silver, and the Spaniard, Javier Garcia, gets the bronze.